I'm feeling a little bit nervous about shopping for my wedding dress. I have a bigger upper chest and have always had bad experiences finding clothes.
Have you tried dresses on at all?
I tried on about 3 dresses, but they weren't really.
In Texas?
Yeah.
Tell me what you're looking for.
I'm looking for something that'll cover up my upper region.
Okay.
That's an issue.
Double D's?
Yeah, like double. Okay. More than that, I don't know.
Really?
We'll see. Okay.
She always has trouble finding clothes that fit her properly.
I hope she finds something that's flattering without being too revealing.
Any pictures of anything that you'd like?
I do have pictures on my phone.
Yes, that's basically the shape of the dress that you're looking for.
I want something clean and simple.
Okay,
I don't
that's
want
one.
Like feathers and flowers.
Okay.
And
what's comfortable for you price-wise with the dress?
I can go up to 3,000.
I love your boots.
Thank you.
Those will be worn with the dress.
So the wedding is in Texas, I'm assuming.
Yes. Okay. It's going to be kind of rustic country, bridesmaids in boots.
All righty. I'm going to do some shopping for
okay.
you. Okay.
With Katie's quest for coverage in mind, Debbie teams up with Randy.
I have this fabulous bride. Wait till you see her boots. She's going to wear her cowboy boots.
Oh.
The only challenge that we do have mm-hmm. is that she's probably a double D, maybe even more.
Okay.
Most bridal gowns come in a B cup, and there's only a certain amount of designers that will make that change of opening the cup or raising the neckline. So she's going to be limited in her selection.
So there's one Jim Helm that she actually does love.
Great.
It's here.
Ah.
Okay. So this is the dress, and I think she picked it because I feel like she thinks she's going to be covered in it.
You never know how a halter is going to be. Sometimes it just accentuates. Strapless with a little dip in the neckline is really nice for a fuller busted bride. However, we have to put her in this dress because she's not going to be able to move forward until she tries this on.
You don't like it?
No, look at my boobs.
Katie?
I like the bottom. I don't like this. Look at all that.
Mom, what do you think?
Look how she's covering up.
I know.
Looking at myself in this dress, I'm horrified with my chest area.
I think that that's gross.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
I think that that's nasty.
It's not what I thought it would be.
It doesn't have to be a halter. It could be a strapless dress.
I don't think strapless dresses are going to look good. Every dress I try on is strapless. I look like I have 4 boobs up here. There's just not flattering or pretty.
A lot of brides think that you're going to be more exposed in a strapless dress, but really that's not always the case. When you've got a deep V neckline or a halter, then you're going to be exposing a lot more.
This could work.
Oh, that's stunning.
Katie, you ready?
Yes.
You're covered up.
I think it's really beautiful on you.
I love this. I didn't think I would like strapless, but I really do like strapless.
Now, don't you feel that you're looking up at your face now and not at your boobs?
Yeah.
This is way better than the last one.
Absolutely. I'm absolutely shocked that I look like this in a strapless dress. I was thinking that I would be spilling over, but I don't fall out like I thought I would.
When they get one that actually fits, are you gonna have this chunk of fat right here that people have? You know what I mean?
I don't like that. Both my daughters wear strapless dresses now and then, and I just don't want them to look too
Okay, come on, let's go.
Undeterred by mom's negative reaction, Debbie keeps her focus on Katie's big concern.
I think what I'm loving about the dress that you have on, believe it or not, there's no pattern change yet, but it's got a nice amount of coverage. I think you should definitely try this one.
Yeah, I'll try that one on.
Okay, let's
for
do
sure.
it.
That one's cute.
The bust on this one is much smaller than the one before this. They can raise this and open it. So they're going to give her a little bit more room in the bust so she'll fall into the dress, and then they're going to raise
out
this.
Of it.
Right, as opposed to spilling out of the dress.
There we go.
Somebody could just come along and pull your clothes off.
How do you feel?
I like everything about this dress, except I just feel like it's a little tight right here.
All right, let's go back in the room.
It's not really something that I think is cute. I hope she finds something that's flattering on her figure.
Isn't that pretty?
It is pretty.
Look at your body in this. I tuck a glove into the neckline, so this would give an illusion of how the dress will look after it's altered to fit Katie. I'm just hoping that mom doesn't shoot it down. I'm hoping my glove trick will work.
You don't like the skirt, do you?
I do.
You do?
You do? How we doing?
This is beautiful on you.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, I think
it's really
beautiful.
Pretty. I feel really pretty when I'm wearing this dress, and I feel like I'm closed in, like I wanted to.
Mom, what do you think?
Well, I've never really liked strapless anything. The girls know that. She looks beautiful in it. She does. I can't believe how good the top of that looks, and it's not anything I would think I would have liked on her.
I was shocked that it's so flattering on her, and that it's strapless, and that I have to admit that I like it.
So, Katie, are we going to say yes
to the dress?
Yes, I'm saying yes! I thought I knew what I wanted, but Randy and Debbie really helped me find a dress and make me feel confident about my wedding.
What's in those boots?
I love it.
Love it.
Much to her surprise, Katie fell in love with a strapless Augusta Jones gown for $2,500.
Hello,
Hi.
How are you? Good morning.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Valerie Mesticelli. I am a teacher, third grade, and I am here today for my first fitting.
You want it out? You can make it floral length. Can I cut it if you don't want it?
I do. Being 4'8½", you can't really carry a big dress, but I wanted the big dress look. So I asked if they could add length to the train and make the bottom a little puffier. And they say the tiers are gonna make me look a little bit taller because my fiance is 6'3". When we first started out looking for my dress, my budget was $3,000, and then that wasn't really cutting it because nothing really fit me right. This dress was a little over $11,000 when I purchased it, which is quite out of my price range. And my father's like, no, try it on. So, this dress better be worth every penny. Something's not right.
Hello.
That's
oh,
beautiful.
God, it's beautiful. It's gorgeous. Beautiful. It's stunning.
It's petite. It's classy. It's almost like a one-of-a-kind dress.
What did you add?
A train. Crinoline underneath to make it puffier.
You like this one more smoother?
Yes.
Yeah, remember I wanted the crinoline to give a poof.
You don't need poof, Valerie.
Dad?
Valerie?
Dad?
It's going to give you the poof in the back.
I don't want to cut before you decide. It's up to you. It's your dress.
What are we doing?
I bust her now.
She's not going to do anything.
I'm not going to take it out.
She's not going to take it out.
I'm still scared. There's still so much to do. A few more little adjustments. It's just hard to see with all these people pulling and tucking. And the dress is beautiful, but I don't know that I look good in the dress.
Finish for today, and we'll see you next time.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Petite bride Valerie was overwhelmed by her family at her first fitting and left the store still unsure about her pricey custom gown.
Now everybody thinks I lost my mind, and I might have.
Now she's back without them for what she hopes will be the last time.
I am anxious, I am nervous, I'm scared. Hopefully, I'll love the dress.
Can I come in?
Yes.
Hello. Wow, this is the way you want it to be.
Yes.
Okay.
Why, you don't like it?
I love it. No, am I? It is the way you like it?
Yes.
Definitely?
Definitely.
Okay, then. Look at you. Gorgeous. Look at how beautiful you look.
Oh, thank you. I definitely feel better. The alterations definitely gave more of that hourglass look. And the tulle underneath, a little fluffier throughout the way that I envisioned it to be. It made me feel, finally, like a bride.
And on her wedding day in Atlantic City, New Jersey, Valerie is every inch the perfect bride.
The moment I saw Val, it was just like the first time I met her. I felt totally in love again.
Adam, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
So now they share in a kiss.
I love you.
Adam said, the dress is beautiful. It's made just for me.
She looked so amazing in the beautiful dress. I'm the luckiest guy in the world.